you're in my seat. Can I just have you move over here for the interview? You know what? No, it's fine. It's fine. We'll just go with it. All right. I'm excited to have our guest here today. He's been in many movies and plays over the last decade. Please join me in welcoming Jake Gyllenhaal. Jake, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Can I call you Jake?
Sure. Yeah. Okay. That's not my name, but yeah.
Oh, what's your name?
I'm John.
Okay, Jake. So I hear you're acting in a new play entitled Eurydice.
Eurydice.
Will this be your first time on Broadway?
Broadway and Alton, yeah.
Doesn't sound like real Broadway to me.
It depends on what you mean by Broadway.
The big one.
Yeah, it's not that at all.
Okay. Just have a couple questions about your acting career. Have you ever, found yourself becoming romantically involved with your co-stars?
Well, I married one of them. Does that count?
Oh. In the play, you married one of them?
No, in the play, we were already married, so
it was after the
play. So you married them twice?
Well, no, because we were already, we were a married couple in the play, and then later we got married in real life.
So you're Mormon then?
No.
Okay. Yeah. Now tell me, what's her real name?
Her real name?
Yeah.
Is Nikki.
Ah, oh, very cool. And your three sons, how long have you been working with them, and do you see a cast change coming anytime soon?
In my sons? Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know.
Are you looking for something?
No, not at the moment. I'm pretty happy with my interviewing career, but I appreciate the offer.
No, I don't see an I don't anticipate a casting change in my sons. Mm.
I do. I'd have to say my favorite role of yours was in Brokeback Mountain, and I've always wondered what was that experience like.
Well, I think for Jake Gyllenhaal, it was probably pretty awesome, and it kind of set him on a new career path. I appreciated the movie. I actually did a project after that called Beyond Brokeback.
I did that while I was in Wyoming.
Fascinating. Mm-hmm. It's funny, no one really mentions the sequel, but
yeah.
And what was that experience like, if you know what I mean?
It was a great experience because it was an opportunity for men and women who were affected by the movie to share their stories, how Brokeback Mountain kind of helped them become more honest and more free with who they were. So it was an extension of the ideas that Brokeback really wanted to communicate.
I guess I have to be a little more specific here. What was it like kissing a man?
Well, again, I think for Jake, it was Heath Ledger. It was probably pretty good.
Jake, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I understand you're in character right now. It just confuses the audience a little bit, if you understand. I heard you went abroad to Ireland this summer. Obviously, this was to research your role, but is there anything else you can tell me?
About Ireland?
Mm-hmm.
It was fantastic. It's an amazing place.
Really?
Yeah.
Mm. How was the leprechaun culture?
Non-existent.
Strange. Do you know what happened to them?
Well, they never really existed to begin with.
Okay. So you're one of those. Okay. I'm just getting news that it seems there's a potato famine in Ireland. Is that correct? Yeah. Did you have any run-ins with the famine while you were there?
Actually, yeah, because while there's not a potato famine going on right now.
Oh, it ended.
Well, several hundred years ago. Well, not several hundred years ago, about 100 years ago.
That is great news.
Yeah. But the impact is very much still there.
Here, I have a picture of you I'd like to share with the audience. And it really begs the question, why did you shave?
I don't know if I shaved so much, it just got a little grayer.
Hmm. Now, you got really in shape for your role as Southpaw. Would you consider doing a sequel?
To Southpaw?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm all about the right hand.
I actually came up with some of the ideas for the names of the sequel, if you'd like to hear them. Northpaw. Mm-hmm. Westpaw. Eastpaw. Southernpaw. But get this, I thought we could do an added twist where Aunt Jemima plays your new wife.
Yeah, that would be a twist.
Just think on that one.
Especially since she's syrup.
She is syrupy sweet. She's a great woman. I hear your most recent job has you playing a professor at the Principia. Is it hard for someone like you to act smart?
Yeah, actually it really is, to be honest. And that's just John speaking, not even Jake. Mm.
It must be crazy to have those conflicting personalities running around in that head of yours.
Yeah, all the time. Hmm.
You probably know a bit about that.
I do. Yeah. Much about it. And you're living in Illinois now, yep. Is that correct? Mm-hmm. And was that decision attributed to your budget?
No, it's attributed to where the job was.
Mm, I see. And switching to a little bit of a different topic, I'd like to know your thoughts on the most recent Trump move to engage Madagascar in guerrilla warfare.
I wasn't aware that he had done that, but it doesn't actually surprise me.
Hmm. Fascinating. I just feel like it's silly to fight with monkeys, but maybe that's just me. And I don't know if you're aware of this, but I read somewhere that Jared Leto used method acting to prepare for his role as the Joker. He took his role so seriously that he actually gave his co-stars dead rats. I guess my question is, would you like a dead rat?
No.
We're going to have to throw that one out then.
Yeah.
And then, I guess finally, do you have any regrets in your acting career?
This moment right now is maybe going to be one of them.
How about Prince of Persia?
Yeah, definitely.
I regret that too. Oh, you can go. You're good. That was the end. I appreciate it.
I like it here.
I guess I will leave then.
Okay.
Very nice to meet you, Jake. Pleasure.
What was your name?
Noah.
Noah, yeah. You too.
Thank you very much.